Hello everyone, welcome here with another CVP today against the legendary Oracle God Haas. Guy who cannon rushed Chaedong to his death, and today we're going to watch how we win and what we scout. It's mostly going to be about that CVP scouting. I will kind of try to explain to you guys what I see, because there's going to be a lot of weird stuff in this game. And yes, it's a real Haas, in case you're curious. If you want the replay, it's always down in the description if you're as confused as I am by this game. Tell me in the comments. Because Haas is going to play a really, really weird style where he will get a lot of tech and not actually use the tech. Mind games, I guess. It's kind of hard to deal with stuff like that. I'm going for the double edge before pool. And I'm going to speed things up a bit in the early game because there's nothing happening at all. Tekka 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 tekka. Hatch hatch gas pool. Super greedy, but he went Nexus first. Did he? No, I think he went Gate Nexus Core. And then the Twilight Council. I mean, this is kind of greedy as well because he does get that quick Twilight Council. My Overlord gets away with like one shot from death. And he's going for the fast DT Shrine, so it's most likely going to be a DT Warp Prism attack, right? Does he kill this one? It doesn't. It's close. Either way, I haven't really seen much right now. I'm now going to get 2 links into his main and I'll see his tech. I think. I have this link right here. We see the Dark Shrine and the Temple Twilight Council. So my response will be to create a couple additional queens, I think, maybe. I'm going to get the Roach Farm, that's for certain, and I think a Fast Lair as well. Getting the Spores to deal with the DTs, because else I might just die to a DT attack. And I'm making some links so I can actually catch the DTs and protect my Spores. I've not seen a Robo, so I'm not quite sure what kind of DT play I'm going to face. And because of that, I'm scouting around, trying to see, did he build a gateway or pylon somewhere? But I scouted this entire area. I don't think there's one over here, and then there's only down here, and I haven't really found anything, so I figured most likely nothing. But Haas is actually just going for Phoenix instead. So when I scouted this, I was like, well, it's probably going to be a DT robo attack. And I was like, well, if he's not building a War Prism or attacking me, then maybe it's like a DT tech where he has a gateway and a pylon here and just warps in mass DTs, makes him into Arcans or something. Then I realized, well, he does have a Twilight Council, so maybe he did get the Adept Glaive upgrade, which he didn't. Because maybe I thought, well, maybe I didn't pay attention, it's actually an Adept attack. I can Adept all in with a DT Shrine behind it. But that was not it either. Instead, Haas is actually going for Phoenix, so I send in an Overlord here because I'm like, what am I even playing against? So I see 2 Stargate, and then I see a Forge and a Robo. So this guy went TC in into a Dark Shrine, made 1 Dark Templar, killed nothing, then built 2 Stargates, started Phoenix production. Then built a Forge and a Robo. Hasn't built anything out of the Robo. Like, it just gets tech and he's safe with DTs, right? I cannot attack him because he has DTs. DTs just kill my stuff. And Overseers will die to the Phoenix, so. I know that he at least made DTs, I guess. And I had to defend against things that weren't even coming just because there's a threat of them coming. And if I don't properly defend against him, I just straight up die. Power of the mind games, when your opponent just builds one of every tech structure. So when I saw this, I'm like, okay. So if I build Overseers, he will kill them with the Phoenix and then warp in DTs maybe. Then he has the Robo, so he might do something with a Warp Prism. But actually he's just flying across the map with his Phoenix and doing a bit of damage, and I'm going for a Ling Hydra attack. Because I need something to kill the Phoenix, so I can't go straight Ravager. You actually have to kill these bad boys. And he has this Archon Immortal Charge Lord army that he's trying to make use of right now. I have a pretty decent army here, but I don't have quite enough banings to deal with all this stuff here. He loses a lot of Archons to this attack, I'm not quite sure if this attack is actually that cost efficient from me. But his charge slots are really cheap and do a lot of damage, but my goal is just to eliminate as many of his tech units as I can and kind of reset him his tech once again. I'm just trying to get his tech all the way down. The charge slots are one thing. They're really cheap, do a lot of damage. Actually, like, charge shots are insane. Really annoying. Look at this. Man, I'm up like 30 supply and I can't fight him. 40 supply almost. 35, I guess. So sad, isn't it? And he makes more DTs. I still have Overseers, luckily. I see the DTs now. My Banings are morphing in kind of a weird place, and his DTs just killed all my Banes, I guess. He loses a lot of his DTs as well. DTs are really expensive. They're like... they cost a lot, but they still do a lot of damage, so they're not to be underestimated, even if you see them. I mean, they die to Banings really quickly and stuff like that, but they're still pretty dangerous. I still keep trying to snipe all his tech units here. And I'm like, well, my supply is dropping really low, but well, he only has 5 units. Then he warps another wave of charge slots and I would have been destroyed there. I do have my 4th base, well, he's pretty much 3 base all in. And it's not really good if you play a 3 base all in and the Zerg has an economic advantage and is pushing you at the front. But he's just making more and more Arcans right now. Just as many Arcans as he can, and Arcans are pretty dangerous. Like, I still don't know what I'm supposed to answer to a lot of Arcans. Like, his army does not look big, but it's really strong. I really have to get links on the Arcans and then kind of do Hydralisk DPS on them. I'm trying to take this base, but I think that's kind of in vain. At this point I was like, I'm actually going to die here, so I just spam links. Make some roaches so I can add a couple more Ravagers. Getting the Lurker, then I'm like, oh shit, that's a lot. So he's, like, he has these two Immortals all game, 17 kills and 5 kills that I can't quite kill. Trying to land some Biles on him, kind of failing. Then he saves the Arcans again in the Warp Prism. Tries to warp in new units, and my Banings are finally able to crush through him here. See him, like, he's trying to save the charge slots, but they end up dying either way. Warp Prism does fall just barely, and we eventually win the game against his 3 base Protoss. Now, to be fair, like, he went Dark Shrine into double Stargate with Phoenix, and the Phoenix didn't really kill much, and he built a Robo. We got like 2 Immortals and then just made Chargelot Arcan. Could have just gone pure Chargelot Arcan to begin with. Either way, I think it was an interesting game. I guess he would have gone Disruptors if that didn't work either. I'm not sure how seriously he took this game, or if this is actually, or if he just figured that, well, if I see the Dark Shrine, maybe it's not going to be that effective, so I'll just go for another tech, or maybe he's like, oh shit, I forgot my Robo. I don't know what was going on. Either way, it was an interesting game. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!